Today I wanted to go over the five most common problems with air conditioners. Let's say you got to turn your air conditioner on, have a cool, then an auto, and you lower your temperature down, and let's say nothing happens. Unit doesn't turn on, the blower doesn't turn on at all. The first things you want to check is a breaker. Could be a trip breaker. You often have a breaker for the condenser and then a breaker for the fan itself. This one's right here for the fan. Just want to make sure your breakers aren't tripped. And sometimes if they're tripped, they'll trip halfway. When you reset it, you need to turn the breaker all the way off and then turn the breaker all the way back on. Next thing to check is the door switch. Often there's a service door switch on the air conditioner unit, and it's usually located right here. What you want to do is push on this left side to see if that'll engage that switch. You've got it on cool and auto already, and a lot of times that can be the problem. Sometimes you might need to add a screw, like this one, a screw's been added to make sure that it's held in place, or to tape the door shut. If you do add a screw, you want to make sure that screw isn't penetrating into anything, like any tubing or anything like that, or refrigerant tubing behind it. So you want to make sure you pick a place that's good, and you don't want a screw that's too long. You don't want it to poke in anything that it's not supposed to. Okay, the number three most common problem with air conditioners. So one, we had a breaker tripped. Two, the service door switch. Third most often cause of an air conditioner not working inside here can be if this hatch comes open. Sometimes, let's say it wasn't secured properly. It's got this, like a mailbox latch that latches the door into place. And if that came open and this hatch falls open, a lot of times what will happen is your evaporator coil will freeze up a block of ice. So while you're there, you got your filter. You might need a new filter. Make sure you have good airflow. But a lot of times what will happen again is that'll turn to a solid block of ice, and you won't even be able to pull the air filter off. What you want to do is come to your thermostat and just turn the cool side off, and just turn the house fan on. So turn the fan on and put the switch here on off. That way you can defrost the air conditioner. And you also kind of want to watch it to make sure your condensation line doesn't overflow, get built up with too much water from the ice melting. So something to keep an eye on there. But keeping the fan on help melt the ice faster and dry everything out, get it back to normal. Takes a little while, and then you'll be able to put it to cool and auto again. Again, you'll close this door, and if you need to, you can add a screw or you can add some tape to make sure that it's held in place and doesn't come open on you again. Number four most common problem with air conditioner is a fan motor that won't start. And often you can just replace the fan start capacitor. I have a video showing you how to do that. First thing to try before you just run out and replace the motor is to try replacing the fan start capacitor. And it's not truly a start cap, it's actually a run cap. But replacing that capacitor helps get the fan started going and gives it that initial kick to start. Without that, it can't start. It might just sit there and hum. And sometimes you can even push start it with a pen or something, you know, very carefully. And the fifth most common cause of losing air conditioning is a faulty thermostat. So you can click on over to my video about how to troubleshoot a faulty thermostat. Anyway, those are the five most common problems with air conditioning that you come across that'll give you a no-cool call. And I have videos on all of those, so you can check them out. I'll try to put the links here, or, you know, put some links on this video so you can click over to watch those. That's the five most common problems with air conditioners.